But, you know, you find that you can just keep going like the Energizer Bunny, right? Hi there, Coach Sage Candido, SageRunning.com here with another training talk. Today we're going to talk about strengths and weaknesses in your running journey, perhaps, and kind of how I would focus on them or not focus on them as time goes on, as you want to progress in your training, whether you're doing a 5K, you're training for a marathon, ultra marathon, mountain running, track running, road running, you name it, any surface, any distance, you've come to the right place. So the idea for this talk came, I was scrolling on the Instagram feeds, and I follow a lot of professional runners, ultra marathon runners, and some of you may know Camille Herron. I'm using her as an example, but her post got the wheels spinning in my head. If you don't know Camille Herron, she's got a lot of records, 24-hour, I believe, 100-mile, some 100-mile speed records, especially for running like on a track in the U.S., and she's also won the Comrades Ultra Marathon, pretty big deal. So great ultra runner. I believe she's also run under 240 in the marathon, a couple Olympic trials. I think her PR is around, I'll put it there, I think it's around 238, maybe 236 in the marathon, don't want to sell her short. But she's mainly known for those 100-mile ultras and Comrades. And an interesting post, she posted a picture of her, I believe, in high school. We'll pull it up there too. And she had mentioned how she had run as a middle distance runner, doing 400 meters and 800 meters mainly, where she ran a 62-second 400 meter and a 2:15 800 meters. And I was already thinking, oh, the 400's even better than the 800. And then she had listed her mile as well, but it wasn't as good relative to those mid-distance things. And I was trying to put it in context to understand it, and she's like, well, actually, my high school track coach was more of a sprint coach, or I think she said sprint or football, and they were doing a lot of low mileage, explosive sprint training workouts, more middle distance focus and sprinting focus, sprinting being under 400 meters or quarter mile. And so her talent and her real ability to really shine at longer distances didn't present itself until later in life. And you might be able to relate to that as well. A lot of you come from, maybe you played a different sport in school when you were younger as a kid. Maybe you played, on a team sport, soccer, baseball, weightlifting, swimming, triathlon, something like that. And then now you're focusing on running and you're just starting to realize that there's untapped potential, but also that you might have different strengths and weaknesses that you didn't even know were there. And over time, as you get older, as you get more mature in your running journey, you'll find that different strengths and weaknesses come out. Now, some of those weaknesses, we should say, are literal physical weaknesses that could cause injury, right? And that's what we want to really try to avoid, so we could get more enjoyment out of running, stay consistent, and train so we actually improve, right? Staying healthy is number one gold standard name of the game, right? Healthy and consistent in distance running, building that aerobic base. But maybe your talent is, your strength could be durability or not getting injured as you start running higher and higher mileage. And especially as you progress in your running, as you get up to over 40, 50 miles a week, 80 kilometers a week, that's pretty serious training, right? Just training for a marathon, you start running that much, you're looking to maybe improve by leaps and bounds. But you can't get injured. And so, you know, different things you might see in your own running journey, and we're all different. I have right now an ankle weakness because I rolled my ankle 3 weeks ago, but I've also had issues as I've gotten more mature in my running journey, running super high mileage, I will say, where I noticed, maybe you're not activating your glutes as much, or your butt muscles, especially on the left side. I got a small left butt cheek, right? So I got to work on that. I start to lose flexibility as well in like my hip flexors. And part of that's from sitting, running high mileage, sitting too much, not stretching enough, running super high mileage, getting older. Maybe there's dietary or genetic things that are all intertwined there, right? Lots of things at play, lots of variables. So I say, you need to focus on those little things. You need to stretch, keep limber, get a good range of motion, open up your stride. But maybe your other focus is that you need to build up your stamina. having trouble saying that word, or endurance, so you're not breathing so hard, right? You get out there, most people, they want to figure out how they're not going to be out of breath when you're running, right? Running's kind of a hard sport. You start getting out there, if you've taken time off or you're just starting out, and it's your heart's up in your lung, in your throat, and it feels like you can't breathe, right? And you start sweating, it's really hot and uncomfortable, and your legs hurt. I mean, that's a normal feeling when you're first starting out and you're getting in shape, right? But as you progress, suddenly those paces become easier. Maybe you run at the same pace for longer distances at even a lower heart rate, right? So I guess the main goal of this talk was to talk about, figure out your own relative strengths and weaknesses. And they could be, it could be like Camille Herron. She had great 400 meter speed in high school and was kind of seen as a sprinter, but then later on in life, and I don't know her exact progression or trajectory, but she did very well running longer distances, and now much longer distances 20 years later or so. So, you know, that's kind of the context of thinking of relative progression. And then the other context of this strengths and weaknesses thing, besides not getting hurt, not getting an overuse injury or having a running form issue or something like that, health issue, is that the way you look at your training block. So again, this is a business plug. Coach Sandy and I co-founded our company, SageRunning.com. We sell training plans for any service, any distance. Link in the description below. You can check out, we have free downloads on the website as well. We got podcasts, stuff like that. But the idea with training plans is you go through time, as you go through a cycle, be it a 12-week training plan or a 16-week training plan, or even looking at your whole training over the course of a season, of several months, or even the whole calendar year, the general trend, and again, this is being kind of general and basic, so to speak, is that you want to focus more on your weaknesses more in the off season and at the beginning of the training cycle. Whereas right before race day, when you're tapering in the last 2 weeks, maybe, you want to focus more on your strengths, right? It gives you more confidence, because if you're doing workouts that you're really good at naturally anyway and they feel good, you get that energy going and that positive attitude going into your race, right? You don't want to be doing some crazy new weightlifting workout that's going to make you sore in weird places the week before your race, right? That could mess things up or injure you worse. So in the off season though, if we're taking a break from training, or maybe for a lot of people in the northern hemisphere, right, colder temperatures are coming up, the weather's kind of bad outside, you might say, oh, let's focus on some targeted specific strength and flexibility training and drills, whether that's gym work, doing some extra little things inside that are gonna help build that strength, that core strength maybe, or that leg strength, or work on those shin muscles to help not get shin splints, or work on those some calf raises so you know you don't strain a calf when you start building up your training again, right? And you do have to be careful with it, and it is very individualized, because you're working on your weaknesses. You're working on your weaknesses, and just learning what your weaknesses are is the first step, really. And you know, I'm still learning some of my weaknesses, sometimes the hard way, right? Sometimes it comes from a painful injury, a fall. Sometimes it comes through a running form analysis. You know, there's a lot of things that, you know, could be weaknesses. Maybe, I don't know, maybe you have 100% strength, so maybe you're great at everything, so more power to you. But the goal is to stay healthy, and then to also realize, hey, maybe I need to build up my endurance and stamina. This is probably the most common thing I see with runners when they start moving up in distance, especially over 10K, half marathon, marathon distance, your stamina starts fading, right? Your endurance, you want to be able to keep a steady pace and not have any big bonks or muscle letdowns or you know, mental meltdowns when you're trying to run these really long distances, right? Because most people could sprint around the block for 100 meters or 200 meters. I can't sprint very fast for 200 meters. You saw in the athlete special form analysis video, I had trouble running a 29-second 200 nowadays, but that's pretty fast for me. I had trouble doing that in high school too. But you know, maybe you could run a 25-second 200. Maybe you run a 45-second 200. It doesn't really matter, because it's all relative to how much can I extend that sprint speed up into a longer distance event. Well, the limiting factors in the long distance events usually come down to your cardiovascular system, what's inside that counts, right? Your heart and lungs efficiency, oxygen utilization, so to speak, but also your fueling, right? Not running out of glycogen too fast, getting your muscles fueled, being able to utilize lactate, saying a lot of scientific words here, but there's that, as well as muscle fatigue, not having your form break down or getting a cramp, calf cramp, not getting dehydrated, right? Things like that, not getting injured when you're training, being able to do long runs and progressively higher mileage. So the stamina, am I saying that word right? Usually comes, English is my first and only language. That comes usually through building that aerobic base. And I've preached about this over and over for the last decade, probably in my videos. But most people get bigger gains in their endurance, so to speak, and they're not breathing so hard, they could run longer, by increasing their consistency of slightly higher weekly mileage, but also doing targeted workouts like the tempo runs, some speed workouts still, but then also the long runs and getting that strength. But you can't get injured, and so sometimes you have to do literal actual strength work, maybe in the gym, maybe at home if you don't have access to a gym, and stretching and flexibility stuff to keep you limber and running with good form, not getting injured, being very progressive and deliberate in your training. And that's really the key takeaway and what I'm going to leave you with, because it's really important. It's really important, and it's about realizing your strengths and weaknesses. And like I said, as you go along in your training plan, you start hitting some bigger, higher mileage, you start doing longer long runs, maybe the longest long run you've ever done, maybe you're running twice a day even, and that's when you start realizing, hey, I like this type of workout. I like doing kilometer repeats close to 5K pace. That's maybe my strength. But maybe my strength's doing the super long runs. I could just keep going forever, and I'm like a camel. I don't have to drink very much, although you should stay hydrated. But you know, you find that you could just keep going like the Energizer Bunny, right? So that could be a strength for you, and you might gravitate towards the longer distances. Other people might try to mix it up, and it is good to mix it up, right? Focus on your weaknesses, do some speed training in the off season, some shorter races maybe, if your target event is longer events, longer races, and vice versa. So, you know, mixing things up, keeping things interesting, keeping things fun. Again, you can check out training tips on a playlist. I got training talks on there. Check out our coaching website, sagerunning.com. Again, I plug that. Thanks to title sponsor, Hoka One One, keeping the dream alive. Hope you're doing well. Thanks to Patreon supporters for making this channel possible. Here's an old throwback to, well, a couple days ago, do what you can with the time you have video. Thanks again. Stay tuned for more.